Before we start dividing by a fraction, let's look at this problem where we're trying to find how many groups. A gift bag is supposed to hold 6 pieces of candy. If you have 15 pieces of candy, how many gift bags can you make? Notice a fractional answer is fine. What we have here is a problem where we are asking how many groups. In this problem, the groups are the gift bags, and we're asking how many groups of 6. Well, one way to approach this is to start looking at my 15 pieces of candy, represented here by 15 rectangles, and breaking them up using the tape diagram into groups of 6. So I want to count off 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if I circle those, what I'm going to be circling is right there, a group of 6. If I do that again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I'm going to be circling a group of 6. So I clearly have 1 group of 6. Here is a second group of 6. It's a little bit difficult to see. Wait a minute, I don't have a full group of 6 here. But I do have half a group of 6. I have 1, 2, 3 pieces of candy. That's half of the 6. So I want to label that and say that what I have is 1/2. So I should be able to make 2 1/2 gift bags. By the way, if we want to think about this in terms of division, we're taking 15, we're dividing that by 6. If I move over and just do a little bit of long division, 15 divided by 6, there's a 2, subtract to get a 12 and a 3. So that is 2 3/6, or 2 1/2. Now, let's try doing that where instead of dividing by something like 6, a whole number, let's divide by a fraction. Notice that I have another how many groups question here. What's different is instead of a whole number, I've got a fraction, 3/4. I'm asking how many are inside 2, and I have my tape diagram to show 1, 2 rectangles. But I can't just count off 6 like I could before. It's 3/4. So I need to add a little bit to this picture. What I need to do is I need to make sure that I'm looking at fourths. So I'm going to start dividing each one of these rectangles that stand for 1 into 4 pieces like this. Some really sloppy dotted lines there, but you get the idea. Please notice that each one of these pieces now stands for 1/4. What I did is I took each of the holes and I broke them into 4 pieces. So now, when I'm looking for groups of 3/4, I want to collect 3 of these together. There's one group. Here's another group. And now we have a little bit of work to do. Notice that this last group right here only has 2/4 and not 3/4. So if I'm looking at this, this is a full group. It's got 1, 2, 3 pieces there. But this isn't a full group. It's a fraction of a group. And I need to figure out what fraction it is. Well, it has 2 pieces out of the 3 that I need. So what I'm saying is that this is 2/3 of a group. Or if I want to write this as a sentence, there are 2 2/3 groups of 3/4 in 2. If I want to write that as a division statement, I'm saying 2 divided up into groups of 3/4 is 2 2/3. I'm going to go over the important steps one more time just to make sure that you've got as much understanding as possible. So we were looking for groups of 3/4 inside 2. We took the holes and broke them up into 4ths because we had 3/4 up there. I circled groups of 3/4. Here's one group of 3/4. Here's two groups of 3/4. And I had a part of a group left over. Looking at this partial group compared to the whole group, I've got 2 pieces there when I was supposed to have 3. So that's 2/3 of a group. And that's how you carry out fraction division with a how many groups problem and tape diagrams.